Steve needs to mix a 20% saline solution with a 12% saline solution to make a 15% saline solution. He wants a total of 16 ounces in the mix. How many ounces of the 20% saline solution and how many ounces of the 12% saline solution should he use? What are we looking for? How many ounces of the 20% saline solution and how many ounces of the 12% saline solution should he use? There's our unknowns. I'm going to say let X represent the number of ounces of 20% solution, and I'm going to let Y represent the number of ounces of 12% solution. So now let's see if we can't write a system for this. So we're mixing a 20% saline solution with a 12% saline solution. We're going to get a 15% saline solution, and specifically, we want a total of 16 ounces in the mix. So we have then that X plus Y must equal 16. The number of ounces of X and the number of ounces of Y added together must be 16. Now, we also need the percentages to work out. So, in the first solution, in the 20% saline solution, we can think, well, how much salt is in that solution? 20% of the solution is salt. 20% of the ounces, then. So, we can then write, since we have a 20% saline solution and X ounces, the amount of salt would be 0.20x. The amount of salt in the second solution, similarly, would be 0.12y. Well, the amount of salt in the first solution, the amount of salt in the second solution, has to be the same as the amount of salt in the mixture. So we mix them together, and in the end, we need 15%, well, 15% of what? 15% of the total ounces. So 15% of 16. And so there's our system of equations. All right, so let's rewrite. X plus Y is equal to 16. And I'm going to clean it up a little bit. 0.2X plus 0.12Y. And 15% of 16 is 2.4. All right, so now let's solve this system. I'm going to use elimination here. So let's see. I'm going to use an elimination on Y. All right, so I'm going to focus on the Y's here, and I have a positive 0.12 in the second equation and a positive 1 in the first equation, so I need them to be opposites. I will multiply the first equation, both sides, by negative 0.12. So that would yield negative 0.12x minus 0.12y, and let's see, negative 0.12 by 16 gives me negative 1.92. The second equation I'm not changing, so I've got a 0.2x plus 0.12y is equal to 2.4. All right, and now I have an elimination on y. I'll add these equations together, yielding 0.08x, a 0y, and let's see, negative 1.92 plus 2.4 yields 0.48, and I'll divide through by 0.08, and that yields that X equals 6, And now since x plus y is 16, then 6 plus y is 16, and subtracting 6 from both sides, we find that y equals 10. Now, as a quick check, now without doing substitutions, let's just sort of look at the originals. We started off with 20% and 12% solutions, and in the end we needed 15%. So 15 is closer to 12, right? 15 is closer to 12 than 20. So I needed to use more of the 12% solution. And I see that I did use more of the 12% solution. Now, does that tell you you're right? It doesn't tell you you're right, but at least it's more reasonable. All right, so conclusion. Steve needs to use 6 ounces of the 20% saline solution, and 10 ounces of the 12% saline solution.